Tony Belli versus Roberto Belmonte for the WBC light heavyweight silver title. Okay, so Tony Belli successfully wins the WBC light heavyweight silver title on Saturday night against Roberto Belmonte. Now, in my pre-fight predictions, I said that Belmonte was slow, flat-footed, one-paced, and didn't know how good he would fight off the back foot. And I really thought that Tony Belli would have blasted Belmonte out of there. So it happens Belmonte got cut. Not Belmonte. Belli got cut. My apologies. Belli got cut and had to change his game plan. Now, from early on in the fight, I don't know if you noticed, but anytime Belli tried to get Belmonte against the ropes, those big arching swinging right hands were going over the top of Belmonte's head, and the crude swinging right hands, and at no point in time did Tony Belli try to shorten up his punches. Given he'd got a cut, he'd want to get too adventurous, but let's be fair, Belmonte didn't throw him any punches back. And Tony Belli, for me, look, I like Tony Belli, but to be honest, I know Eddie Hearn's pushing his career in a certain way to get him the fights, but, and people saying look great against Belmonte, but Belmonte, for me, although he got a WBC 5 world ranking, honestly, he didn't look world class to me. There were many openings that Tony Belli left in his defence in this fight before he got cut, and he was getting caught. Given he took the punches, but it wasn't the sort of performance that I would have been jumping up and down and raving about. And like I said, a lot of his punches were missing, and he was unable to throw punches in close. And at no point in time, I know Belmonte went down in one of the rounds, but he never looked seriously hurt. And at world level, I do question whether Tony Belli is a bit too predictable, and his punch power is, he hits concussively enough at world level. I'm talking about British and Commonwealth level, or even European, I'm talking about world level. The question mark about his punch power. Yeah, he did the 12 rounds, his fitness was good. His boxing brain's pretty decent. He was able to box as he does, cautiously, once he got the cut. But, you know, again, it's another Belli performance, which he looked okay. Like the Miranda fight, he looked okay, but there was nothing devastating in what he did. Then you look at what Nathan Cleverley did the other day against a guy called Sean Hawke, you know, and Cleverley went out there and he beat the living daylights out of Sean Hawke, and he made it exciting as well. Belli looks good when he's boxing on the defensive, to be honest. When he's coming out swinging crudely with all these punches, he does leave himself open. And you ask yourself the question, can he take that same approach against someone like Chad Dawson in the light heavyweight division? Or against Jean Pascal? Or Travers Cloud? You know, these guys, you know, is he good enough to fight these guys? I don't know. I'm not sure. I do like Tony Belli, but the last two fights I've not really been convinced of. But anyway, congratulations to Tony Belli in this fight. Where he goes here from here, I don't know. I'm in no rush to see him fight Chad Dawson, to be honest. To be honest, I think his best shot would be a rematch against Nathan Cleverley. But it's just my opinion. All right, I'm out.